Welcome to this next lecture on microcontroller and its application. So continuing with our series of video lectures, today we'll discuss about input-output port structure of 8051 microcontroller. So as we have studied already while introducing the architecture of 8051, 8051 has four ports: port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3. And each of these ports have 8 lines or 8 bits, and each of these lines can either act as input or as an output port. They can read a data from an external device or they can write a data into an external device. So that is basically what is a port. Let's see in detail each port. So you have these port 0. Now each port have some specific functions apart from being as a simple input output port. Now port 0 is also a simple input output port. It can read a data from an external device and can write a data into an external device. The lines of port 0 are also multiplexed with address data line multiplexed, AD0 to AD7. So when it is not being used as an input or output line to write a data into an external device or read a data from an external device, it may be used as a lower order address data line, which is used for interfacing external memory device with 8051 microcontroller. Now, one more thing to be noticed is port 0 is the only port which requires an external pull-up resistor. Now, pull-up resistor is something which is used to keep your microcontroller constantly in a specific value so that the values on the microcontroller port pins are not floating, which otherwise when read can create an error value. So that is why a pull-up resistor of 10 kilo ohm is what most widely is used. That is what is port 0. You can see the port 0 structure. Now in the port 0 structure, as you can see, there are two buffers to read the pin data and to read the latch bit. Now to read the latch bit, that means to read the information that was present on the port pin already. Okay. Now this latch bit, latch means, as you know, latch is a device which stores the last written value on it, and unless and otherwise the value is reset or overwritten, the value is not erased, the value stays there. So latch bit. So you can read a latch bit or you can read a pin data. Read the pin data is a value that an external device may be sending to your microcontroller port. That is what is pin data. Now that is controlled. Whether the microcontroller should read a latch bit or a pin data is controlled by this control logic. And the latch that we use in all the ports of 8051 is called as D-latch. So D-latch is a latch, as we all know, which works with this principle. That is, whenever your clock frequency is high, whenever you have a clock frequency or a high pulse, and during that time any input change that occurs is recorded, and the other time the input changes is not recorded, and last input change is recorded and kept unless and otherwise it has been deleted or overwritten, unless and otherwise there is a hard reset or it is overwritten. So that is basically what is a latch. So that is port 0. Port 1 is another 8-bit port, in which you have again the almost the same structure, but only difference between port 0 and port 1 is port 1 has the only functionality of reading a data or writing a data to an external device. It does not have any multiplexed operation. Port 1 lines are only dedicated for input-output operation. It does not do any other operation. So port 1 is dedicated input-output port. Apart from this, one more thing to note is port 1 does not require external pull-up resistors. There is an internal pull-up resistor already given in port 1. So that is port 1. And port 2, as you can see, is another 8-bit port. Again, a port 2 has a multiple functionality of being in higher order address lines. As you can see over here, port 2 has higher order address lines A to A15 housed in the same lines. So whenever your microcontroller is engaged in with an external memory device for writing or reading a data to a ROM or an external RAM, then port 0 and port 2 lines are engaged as address data lines. So at that time, you cannot use your port 2 for simple input-output operation. They will be engaged in doing memory operation. So again, in this port 2, you don't require an external pull-up. Internal pull-ups are already present. Now, whether it should act as an address line, whether it should act as a port for writing a data into an external or reading data from an external device is decided by this control logic. Okay, and all the other functionality is same as we saw in port 0 and port 1. So that's what is port 2. Let's see port 3. Port 3, as you can see, is another multiplex port in which every line is having a multiple operation. Rather, other than being port a port where all the lines can read or write data, it can also do these alternate functions. That is, your serial data inputs, external interrupts, external timer interrupt, and then you have external memory write or read pins. All these are also housed in your port 3 lines. So port 3 line also has a multiple functionality. Each line has a multiple functionality of either being a serial communication line like receiver transmitter or interrupt line, external interrupt line like interrupt 0, interrupt 1, or timer input lines like T0, T1, or redirect pins. So again, it does not require an external pull-up. There is already an internal pull-up. So the only port that requires an external pull-up is port 0. So that's what about port configuration in 8051. Just to revise, there are four ports. Each port has eight lines, and each line can be used for either input or output operation. Apart from this, as we discussed, there are some multiplex operation for three ports, that is port 0, port 2, and port 3. Port 1 does not have any multiplex operation. Thank you.